Happy Saturday, everybody. All right, this morning we are going to do part two of the Eagle / Side Crow Saturday series. In part one, we worked on Eagle Pose specifically. In part 1.5, which I completely made up after I did Eagle, we did Side Crow. Part two, we are going to combine the two together, and we are going to do Side Crow with Eagle Legs. Now, in thinking about this, you know, I thought some of you, it's really cold, the floor's cold. I thought that some of you may be really good at Side Crow, and this will be easy. Some of you may not be good at Side Crow, but you're good at things like headstand. So I might throw in the option to do headstand with Eagle Legs, like other things that we can do. But there's so many places to stop along the way. So, as always, do what you can. Have fun. Take a break when you need a break. And just enjoy this time, all right? This is your time on the mat. If nothing else, just sit and breathe, okay? All right, let's get started in supine baddha konasana today. So come to your mat. Lie down. If you don't want to start that way, start in a different way because we're all going to meet in downward facing dog eventually, right? Not eventually, pretty soon. So find a spot where you want to be. I'm saying supine baddha konasana. You might be saying something else, and that's cool. So let's get ready. Find your spot. Begin to notice your breath. Entering and exiting. Notice your body. How is it feeling this morning? What is tense or sore? What feels good? My allergies are absolutely horrible today. My head is hurting. My nose is stuffy. I didn't really want to do this, but here I am. And maybe you're in that place. You didn't really want to do this, but you unrolled your mat and you showed up anyway. And we know that we are going to feel so much better when this is over. So I guess what I'm saying is gather up all of that negative stuff you may be feeling right now, all the aches, all the worry, all of the stuff that is not serving you. Take a deep inhale. Exhale it out. Inhale. Exhale it out. One more time, inhale. Exhale it out. Tap into the breath that serves you right now. Maybe it's your Ujjayi breath. Maybe it's your Equal breath. Maybe you're like me and your allergies are so bad and your nose is stuffy and the best you can do is just breathe. Find a breath that takes away tension. Find a breath that brings stillness and equanimity to the mind, to the body. Supine baddha konasana, I want you to bring your knees together. Bring your knees into your chest, wrap your arms around your knees. Gently rock from side to side or take any movements that feel good to you right now.
When I come here, I like to roll my ankles out, maybe roll my head from side to side. Come back to center. Take your left leg long on the floor. Take your right leg up to the sky. Very gently stretch out the back of that right leg. If you can reach your toes, that's great. I can't do it without lifting up, so I'm just going to grab the back of my leg. I want you to point your toes towards the sky. Stretch the top of your ankle. Point your toes towards your chest. Stretch the back of your calf. To the sky, to the belly, to the chest. One more to the sky, to the chest. Roll that ankle out. Go in both directions. Bring the knee back into the chest. I want you to open the knee up to the right. Start to stretch the inner thigh. Keep the left side of your body grounded. Bring the knee back to the chest. I want you to take a half happy baby. Super gentle here, okay? Do the best you can. If you can't quite reach the outside of your foot right now, grab the back of your leg. So you want to bring that right knee towards the right armpit. Left side of the body stays grounded. This is too much right now. Modify. Remember, grab the back of your leg. Release. Right leg's going long. Full body stretch. Arms overhead. Point the toes. Arch the back. Really bring that left knee in. Take the leg up to the sky. Grab anywhere you can while leaving the shoulder blades on the mat. Point your toes towards the ceiling. Point your toes towards your chest. Left foot, toes towards the ceiling. Toes towards the chest. Towards the ceiling, towards the chest, and roll that ankle out, that left foot, roll it out, go in both directions. Bend the knee. Open it up to the left. Right side of the body stays grounded. You can even tee that right arm to kind of help ground the right side of your body. Bring your knee back to center. Half happy baby. So grab the outside of your foot or the back of the leg. Bring that left knee down towards the left armpit. Keep the right side grounded. This is a whole lot right here right now. So again, if you need to back off a little bit, you can grab the back of your left leg. Do it. Release. Left leg long. One more full body stretch. Bring the knees into the chest. Rock and roll your way up to a tabletop position. Wrists under the shoulders, knees under the hips. Take your knees hip width distance apart, toes together, sink back into a child's pose, hips to heels. Walk the fingertips out, sink down and settle. Unfold into your downward facing dog. Fingers spread wide, press into all 10 fingertips. When you get there, you know what to do, y'all. Pedal it out. Stretch out those legs. Actually, stretch out whatever feels good right here, right now. Settle in. Let your shoulders soften. Press the mat away. Bend your knees as much as you need to. Your hips are high. Look at your toes. Make sure your second toes are pointing straight ahead. Take your gaze in between your hands. I want you to step up to a ragdoll pose. Feet are going to land behind the wrists. Take whatever you need here. Bend your knees a lot. You can let your fingers kind of sway on the mat. You can grab opposite elbows and let yourself sway. Or you can just hang, letting the heaviness of your hands on your elbows pull you down, stretching your upper back out. Release. Heel toe your feet to hip width distance apart. Remember, this is hip width distance, right? If you put two fists in between your feet, that's hip width distance. Second toes pointing straight ahead. Slowly roll yourself up, always using that core. Inhale your arms up. Hands come to the heart, close your eyes. Set your intention for your practice or your day or your life in general right now. My intention's been the same almost every day recently. I'm going to change the wording a little bit, but today my intention is to not worry. I'm living right here in this moment. I'm living right here, right now, where my feet are planted. And right now, my feet are planted on my mat with you guys. It's all I have to worry about. Whatever your intention is, take a deep inhale. Long exhale. Open your eyes up. Let's warm up with some sun A's and some sun B's. Inhale your arms up. Forward fold. Halfway lift. Step back to your plank. Vinyasa through. I'm going to call the first one. Then you can do whatever you want to. Modify as you need to. Tip forward. Chaturanga. Up dog or cobra. Downward facing dog. Now your modification is to just hold your plank. Look in between your hands, step or hop forward, halfway lift. Forward fold. Ground through the feet, rise up, inhale up. Exhale, fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, vinyasa through. Remember, you can just hold your plank or you can plank chaturanga, up dog, down dog. Look in between your hands, step or hop, halfway lift. Forward fold. Rise up. Forward fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, vinyasa three. Downward facing dog. Let's take five breaths in our down dog.
Chair plane.
Alright. Press the fingertips down towards the mat. Sweep the arms up. Chair pose. I didn't quite know where I was going there for a moment. Forward fold. Halfway lift. Plant the hands vinyasa through. Meet me in downward facing dog. One breath to one movement. Let's go. Right leg lifts. Inhale. Exhale. Warrior one. Rise up. Inhale. Exhale. Plant the hands vinyasa through. You have the option to take a one leg vinyasa. Down dog. Sweep the leg. Inhale. Exhale, warrior one, left side, rise up, inhale. Exhale, take it down. You have the option of one leg vinyasa. Downward facing dog, let's breathe. Whew, that'll eat you up. One more inhale. Exhale. Look in between your hands, step or hop forward, halfway lift. Forward fold. Roll yourself up, inhale up. Bring your hands to your heart. Let's take a couple deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, your arms up. Let's take a lean to the right. Any arm variation you choose. Inhale up. Left. Inhale up. Forward fold. And halfway lift. I want you to take a big step back with your left foot. Find your warrior one. Rise up. Now, we're going to take a warrior one with eagle arms here. So I want you to tee your arms. I want you to bring your right arm under your left, elbows forward, fingertips up. Sink deeply into that knee, still bringing that left hip and left shoulder forward. Elbows forward, fingertips up, lean back just a little bit. Come forward, bring the elbows towards the hips, still sinking into that right knee. So we're in this humble warrior. Come back up to a flat back position. Now I want you to step your left foot up, finding a warrior three with eagle arms. If you fall out, it's okay, come back, almost hit. Send your fingertips forward, send your left heel back. One more breath. Rise up, unwind the arms, inhale up. Left knee comes in line with the hip, one leg mountain. Eagle. Left ankle's going to cross over. Left knee's going to cross over right knee. Left arm this time is going to cross under right. Elbows forward, fingertips up. Find your ankle. Squeeze everything into midline. Tuck your tail. Elbows forward, fingertips up for three. Two. One. Unwind. Inhale up. Hands to the heart. So what we did there. Warrior one. Warrior one with eagle arms. Warrior three with eagle arms. One leg mountain, eagle, okay? We switch rights and lefts a little bit, so just listen up, you got it. Inhale up. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift, take a big step back with your right foot. Warrior one, bottom half, rise up. Now, when you get there, to your arms. Left arm under, right arm over, eagle. Elbows forward, fingertips up. Bring that right hip and right shoulder forward. Sink deeply into that knee. Ground through your feet. Send the elbows up towards the sky. Tiny little back bend. Humble warrior with eagle arms. We're going to send the elbows down to the inside of that left knee. Sink deeply into that knee. Come up to a flat back, right? Eagle arms are still here. Walk that right foot up. Warrior three with eagle arms. Now I want you to point farther forward with your fingertips. I want you to press through your right heel and hold this for three. For two. On one, I want you to unwind the arms. Rise up one leg mountain. That right knee is going to be in line with the hip. Let's find an eagle. Right knee is crossing over left knee to your arms. Right arm, oh Lord Jesus, is going to cross under the left arm. Elbows forward, fingertips up, sink. Squeeze everything into midline. Tuck your tail for three. For two. For one. Unwind. Inhale up.
Hands come to heart center.
All right, we're going to try parts of that one more time. All right. Maybe not all of it. Maybe not the fold. Maybe not the back bend, but definitely the eagle. All right. Come to the top of your mat.
Inhale up. Exhale, fold.
Halfway lift. Come back to your plank. Vinyasa through. Meet me in downward facing dog. Sweep your right leg to the sky. Right foot comes through. Warrior one. Go ahead and take your eagle arms. Right arm under left. So right knee is bent, right arm under left. Step it up. Warrior three with eagle arms. Left leg lifts. Press your fingertips forward. Press through that left heel. Unwind the arms. One leg mountain. Left knee is in line with the hip. Eagle, left knee crosses over right. Left arm crosses under right. Elbows forward, fingertips up. Squeeze everything into midline, engage your core. Unwind, inhale up, very nice. Hands to the heart, breathe. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step back to plank. Vinyasa through. Downward facing dog. Inhale the left leg up. Bring the foot through. Warrior one. Go ahead and take your eagle arms. Left arm under right. Warrior three with eagle arms. Step that right foot up. Remember, press through your right heel. Press through your right fingertips. Unwind, one leg mountain. Those arms are going to lift up. Right knee's in line with the hip. Eagle, cross your right arm under your left. Right knee across your left knee. Unwind, inhale up. Have a seat on your mat. If you need to grab a sip of water, I have a coffee cup of water this morning. Grab it. So I feel like we didn't do a whole lot. But it was very cardio intensive, right? It was very hot. I also have this heater, the one in front of me, because it's cold outside today. All right, let's get our core fired up because we're working on arm balance. And what do we need for arm balance? You think you need strong arms, right? You need strong shoulders. Well, you do, but more importantly, you need a strong core. So let's work it out a little bit. Come on down. So I'm gonna try a side for a crunch, okay? I practiced this like one time and I don't really know how this is going to work, so let's see what we got. We expect you to remember how this. This is very typical of me live and in person, too. All right, I want you to take your left leg long on the mat. I want you to bring your right knee in and up. Interlace your hands behind your head. I want you to take the left elbow over towards the right knee. So we're in this this yogi bike situation, right? I want you to leave your upper half just like this. Exactly like this. I want you to take your right leg out, let it hover above the floor, bring it in. Let that knee, maybe even touch your left elbow. Take it out and in. I don't usually let you touch, but I'm gonna let you touch today, okay? But still, even doing this, I feel my core working, okay? Leg out and in. Leave the chest lifted up. Let's go five, four, this is pretty good actually, three, two, one, bring that right knee into the left elbow. Now I want you to pulse the left elbow up for eight. Oh God, seven, six, there we go. Five, four, three, two, one. Jesus Christ, y'all, damn. Right leg stays long, bring that left knee in. Interlace the hands behind the head, lift up. This time, right elbow's going to that left knee. Extend that left leg long. Bring it in. Maybe you tap the right elbow. Long and in. Long and in. So your core is doing absolutely every bit of the work to bring that knee in. Five. Four. Keep lifting up. Three. Two. One. Bring that knee in. I want you to pulse the elbow to the knee this time for eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Release. Oh Oh my God, Jesus Christ. Whew. Take your arms down by your side. Walk your feet in. I want you to lift up into a bridge, but I want this to be like an easy feel-good bridge, so I'm going to push my belly up. I'll tell y'all never to do that, but do that now, because I just need to, like, be here and feel good for a minute. Feel that belly up. Bring it down. All right, eagle crunches. These are killer, y'all, absolutely killer. I want you to take your right knee over your left knee, find eagle legs. All right, if your right toes don't wrap around the left foot, left leg, no big deal, just squeeze it together. I really just want your knees crossed. All right, right elbow under left. So we are in eagle pose, lying down, right? I want you to press your heels towards the top of the mat. Press your fingertips towards the back of the mat. Now I want you to crunch up, elbow to knee. Take it back down, press it out. In, and out. In, and out. Let's go 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, 1, unwind. I want you to make a star shape. Take your legs out. Take your arms out. Lift your back arch. So we were all closed up in that eagle. I want you to just open up wide. Whew. I don't know if I was ready for this, y'all. I don't know if I'm ever ready for this. All right, come on back up. Other side, unfortunately. Left knee's going over the right. So again, it doesn't matter if you can wind the foot. Maybe winding the foot around is more accessible lying down. Left arm's going under right. All right, I want you to press the toes towards the top of the mat, press the fingers towards the back of the mat, crunch it up. Take it down, and up, down, and up. Keep breathing. 8, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, open up, star shape, whew. Oh Lord Jesus, thank God I ate my hashi this morning, but you know what, tomorrow's Easter, and I plan on eating a whole lot of Reese's Pieces and Reese's Cups, and Rooster Bunnies, and Rooster's Eggs, so this will all be worth it, okay? I promise. All right, bring the knees back together. Let's take a little twist before we get moving again. I want you to let your knees fall to the right, gaze to the left. Adjust your shoulders, feel good here. Come back to center with the knees, let the knees fall to the left, gaze to the right, readjust your shoulders. Bring your knees up, rock and roll your way to a tabletop position. Let's do some cats and some cows. We didn't do that earlier. And my belly for sure could use some stretch. Here, special. Use some stretching out right now. So we have two more short little flows before we get to our arm balances for today and wind this thing down. Come back to your long neutral spot. I want you to take a child's pose before we get moving again. We're going to stay in this child's pose for 5 breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. 3, 2, 1 more. Downward facing dog. Right leg sweeps up. Open your hip. Right shoulder down. Let this feel good. I want you to sweep that right foot all the way through again between the hands. Bring your left knee down. Alright, let's take a little side stretch here. We don't need this very often in this pose. I want you to take your left hand down, sweep the right arm up, and I want you just to lean over to the left. I actually have to walk my left hand out to the outside of my mat a little bit. Bring that right hand back down, find your low lunge. Bring your hands to your heart. Let's take a twist, left elbow right there. I gotta fix my hair, this is ridiculous.
And I helped myself into this twist a little bit this morning. All right, if you're having trouble with stability here, you can curl your right toes under. If your foot's flat, really press the top of the foot into the mat. Unwind. All right, we're gonna take this straight to warrior two. Fingertips down. Curl your left toes under, lift the foot up, knee up. I want you to go ahead and put that left foot parallel to the back of the mat. Cartwheel your arms up, warrior two. Bend deeply into that right knee. Left shoulder opens up, even though I can't see y'all, I'm telling you what I'm doing, right? Left shoulder opens up, sink a little deeper. Hold it here. Straighten your right leg. Left hand down, right arm up, reverse your triangle, side stretch, stretch it up. Cartwheel your hands down. Right foot is gonna meet left. Pedal your plank out. You know, my sneaky ways to get y'all to hold planks. Come to your plank. Hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2. Come into your downward facing dog. If you wanted a vinyasa through, you can do it. I'll wait here for you for a breath. Left leg lifts, inhale. Open the hip up, left shoulder down. Let it feel good. Bring that left foot all the way through, right knee's coming down. Press it down here. All right, take that right hand almost maybe to the outside of your mat. We're gonna sweep that left arm up and over, fun, soft stretch. Back to center. Bring your hands to your heart. Let's take our twist. Right elbow, left knee. Puff yourself out a little bit if you need to. Remember that back foot, press into the top of the foot or curl the toes under if you need a little stability. Unwind. We're coming into our warrior two. Curl your toes under, lift the right knee up. Right foot's gonna plant parallel to the back of the mat. My left knee is super bent. I'm gonna leave it right here. I'm gonna cartwheel my arms up, warrior two. Open that right shoulder, you're right here in the present. So as soon as I came up, I was here. I don't wanna be hanging out in the future. It is not a good place for my head to be hanging out. I don't wanna be hanging out in the past. Also a real sketchy fucking neighborhood. Right here in the center, sink deep. What am I talking about? My neighborhood's a sketchy neighborhood. Maybe time of day. I gotta fix my ponytail. Straighten your left leg. Right hand down, left arm up. Reverse your triangle. Cartwheel it down, y'all. Left foot steps back. Knee right. Find your plank. Pedal your plank out. I am not fixing my ponytail. Hold your plank for 5, 4, 3, 2. On one, downward facing dog or vinyasa through if you need to do it. Inhale your right leg to the sky. Open your hip. This time flip your dog if you want to. Or take a wild thing. Whatever you got this morning, go for it. Come back to your three-legged dog if you flipped. Bring your right foot all the way through. This time we're going into a revolved triangle straight from here. Left foot's going down, parallel to the back of the mat. You're gonna sweep those arms up, cartwheel them up, straighten the right leg, left hand down, right arm up. Cartwheel both hands down on either side of that right foot. Walk yourself up to the ground in warrior. We might do that whole thing again because that was really cool. And I may not have explained it well. From here, we're going into a one-leg mountain. Ground through that right foot, begin to lift yourself up. Left knee comes in line with that left hip.
Take your arms wherever you need to take them. Squeeze everything into midline. Left foot comes down to meet right, mountain pose. Inhale the arms up. Forward fold.
Halfway lift. Plant the hands, step back to your plank, vinyasa through.
So we're gonna do that on the other side, then we're gonna do it again because it was really cool.
Inhale your left leg to the sky. Open the hip, flip it, or take a wild thing. Maybe this time I'll take a wild thing, next time I'll flip my dog. Come back to your three-legged dog.
We're going straight into a reverse triangle. Left foot's coming through, right foot's going parallel to the back of the mat. I'm gonna do this one slowly. Cartwheel the arms up, straighten the left leg as you come up, right hand down, left arm up.
Cartwheel the hands down.
Grounded warrior, we're gonna walk that right foot up.
Hands stay on the ground for a grounded warrior, remember.
Ground through that left foot. We're going into a one leg mountain. See if you can rise up without falling out. If you do fall out, it's fine, come back.
Find your balance. Right foot down.
Beautiful job, everybody. All right, let's do that little sweep through to reverse triangle one more time because it's so pretty and it feels so good and so flowy and so free, and I think we all need a little bit of that right now, right?
Come to the top of your mat.
Actually, before we do that, let's go into a chair twist just to prep us. Bring your big toes together. Heels apart, sink into your chair. We're going to take a twist to the right, left elbow, right knee. Bring the heart to meet the hands. Take that right shoulder away from there. So here I was. I want to be here. All right. Make sure your knees are in line. Make sure that right hip's not sticking out. Press that left elbow into that right knee a little more. Maybe take your gaze up. Find your twist. If you want to practice your side crow here, you're going to go deeper. You're going to plant your hands on the floor. Maybe this is just where you stay and you come back to that side crow in a bit. Maybe you hop up into a side crow. Remember from last week, your right hand stays glued to the floor. Your right hip is what comes to the tricep. You lift forward. Press forward. If you went your side crow, come down. We're all going to rise up. Inhale up, meet mountains. Chair pose, hands at heart center. Let me turn me to you. Right elbow, left knee. Now, again, left shoulder goes away from the ear. Now, my right hip went out a little bit. I'm going to bring it back into center. If your left hip went out, bring it back to center. You're going to stay right here. You're going to sink down and prep for your side crow or hop into your side crow. Hands are going down. Remember, my left hand stays glued. It does not move. I bring my left hip to my left triceps. Begin to tip forward. Side crow. All right, come back out of it. If you want to rock and inhale up, meet mountain pose. All right, let's go through that little flow one more time. We're gonna come back to our chair twist or our side crow, and then we're gonna add those eagle legs to some things, okay? Top of the mat.
Inhale up. Exhale, fold.
Inhale, halfway lift. Plant your hands, vinyasa through. We meet in downward facing dog.
Before we go anywhere, let's breathe here. Big inhale. Exhale. Big inhale. Exhale. Inhale, sweep your right leg to the sky. Open up, flip your dog, or take a wild thing. Last time I took a wild thing, this time I'm going to flip my dog. So if you don't know the difference, here you go.
Come back to your three-legged dog. We're going straight into our reverse triangle. Right foot sweeps through, left foot goes parallel to the back of the mat. Cartwheel the arms up, right leg straightens, left hand to left leg, right arm reaches up and back.
Cartwheel it down.
Right foot meets left this time. We're not going into grounded warrior, vinyasa through. Downward facing dog, breathe, inhale.
Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale the left leg up. Open the hip. Flip your dog or take a wild thing. Again, I'm going to flip my dog. Last time I took a wild thing, so if you don't know the difference, here you go. Come back to your three-legged dog.
Reverse triangle, bring your left leg through, right foot parallel to the back of the mat. Cartwheel up. Cartwheel down. This time step your right foot up to meet your left, halfway lift. Forward fold. Big toes touch, chair pose, hands at heart center. Take your twist to left elbow, right knee. Stay right here or side correct. You're gonna take it all the way down, sink down, plant your hands, right hand stays blue. Right hip, always want you guys to see everything I'm doing. Right hip comes straight to the tricep, lift up. All right, if you're here, maybe you work on taking your legs straight. Maybe you work on taking one straight, leaving one behind. There's so many things to do. Plant the foot. Side crow is not my favorite, y'all. I used to be able to straighten my legs. Then my big meaties got so big and meaty that I don't straighten them anymore. That's okay. We're all in a different place, all right? Come back to your chair. Left elbow. Wait. Right elbow, left knee. Twist your chair. Sink deep. Plant your hands. All right, left hand stays glued. Left hip swings around to meet the left tricep. The hip has to sit above the elbow, okay? Has to. Tip forward. Because if not, you're just going to fall on your butt, which is fine. Side crane. Maybe you're able to straighten your legs out. Come out of it. All right, have a seat for just a minute. Roll your wrists out. So I always feel like that's so much. That's a lot. And we're not together. And so I'm trusting you at home just to practice and play, right? As always, if you have any questions, ask me. Ask me on Facebook. You can ask me under the YouTube comments. Send me a message. Jen Newton. You'll find me. All right? I got a little sip of water, and then we are going to move on to the Twisted Eagle. So Twisted Eagle, exactly like our chair twist, but an eagle, all right? So come on up. I'm gonna face you so you can see me instead of facing sideways. Come into your chair. Right knee is gonna cross over left knee. All right? Squeeze everything into midline. If you cannot wrap the foot around, now again, when I wrap the foot around, everything comes forward. I gotta bring it back. Everything squeezes together. That's fine. Just press everything into midline, okay? Eagle twist. You're gonna sink deeper. I want you to take your left elbow to your right knee. All right? So here we are. We're in a twisted eagle. Hang out right here. Practice this. We're gonna do the other side, and then I'm gonna show you how to get to side crow from here, okay? Twisted eagle. Come up, unwind, shake it out. All right, this time I'm gonna show you what it looks like from the side. Chair pose. Eagle, left knee's going over right. Squeeze everything into midline. Sink a little deeper. Right elbow to the left knee. All right, really ground through that left foot. Twisted eagle, all right. So this is a lot of balance work right here, you know? All right, come out. Okay, now we are going to practice that, but we're going to take that into the side crow, and you can probably already see how we go from that into side crow, right? So we're going to come back into our twisted eagle. Yes, I'm going to do it here. Now, if you can nail this, it looks really cool, it looks really pretty. I used to be good at it, I'm not so good at it anymore, and that's totally okay. We're still going to try, we're still going to practice it. So I guess what I'm saying is don't get discouraged if it's hard, because it is really, really hard, okay? But that's why I taught you side crow, and that's why I taught you these in the previous videos, these just practicing, just like those prep poses for side crow. This is where 1 and 1.5 comes in handy, all right? Because there's lots and lots of things there that you can do. Side crow with eagle legs. Chair pose. I'm leaving out some steps. Alright, right knee crosses over left. Find your eagle legs, whatever that looks like. If that hip came forward like mine did, bring it back. Come into your twisted eagle. Now, where do I go from here? I'm gonna bring my hands down to the floor. Now, check
check this out. My foot's gonna come out if it's wound up. That's okay. Now, my knees are still crossed. My hands are on the floor. I'm gonna keep this right hand glued down, okay? I'm gonna swing my right hip around just like I do in our side crow. Going into my side crow now, I'm gonna rewind my legs. And here I am in side crow with eagle legs. All right, so, as you saw, you do get into your eagle legs. You unwind a little bit, but then it's easy to wind back up. So if you start wound up and you unwind a little bit, you don't have so far to go to wind back up. Rather than trying to get into side crow and then eagle your legs, I think that's really hard. May not be so hard for you, okay? That's just how I do it. So let's try it on the other side. And this side's better because my legs don't completely wind anyway. And we'll just see what happens there. Some of you may be like, what the fuck is she doing? I get it, okay? Totally get it. In that case, you just sit here with your jaw dropped, being like, what's wrong with her? I don't know. Maybe I've been home too long. I don't know what's wrong with me. But I'm never gonna do it, okay? All right, chair pose. Left knee crosses over, right. Come into your twisted eagle. All right, here we go. Down to the floor. All right, so see, my legs are not even sort of eagle wound up. That's okay. Bring your left hip around to your left tricep. I may not even be able to do it on this side, y'all. All right. Squeeze the legs back together. So this is totally not my good side, right? But that's where I am on that side. It was not pretty, was it? Let's try that one more time on both sides. And then I'm going to give you your headstand eagle leg options. All right? So that left side was so hard for me. My hands were too close. My hip wouldn't get to my arm. I'm human, okay? I teach you how to do it, but that doesn't mean that I'm perfect at it. I'm not. All right? So that's why we're going to practice both sides again. And if you are there and you're like, this is just an absolute zero, not working, practice your side crow. Or those prep moves, or twisting your eagle, all right? All right, let's come into our eagle on the right. Take it down, find your side crochet. Bring your right hip to your right tricep. Side crochet, see if you can rewind the legs. All right, let's try it on the other side. Maybe you found something that works better for you than what I just did, okay? All right, I am like struggle bus huge on this side. All right, see, all I can do is squeeze my legs together here. It's okay. All right, there we go. So we practice that, or we just practice our side crow. Now, for those of you that are having a lot of trouble but are really good at inverting, I'm gonna show you how we eagle leg our headstand, okay? And then we are done with this mess today, y'all, okay? This has been a really challenging one. I'm gonna show you two different ways to headstand with eagle legs. I'll do the first one on the right, and then I'm gonna do supported on the right, and I'll do tripod on the left. How about that? All right, I'm gonna do the first one face facing you, and the second one I will do sideways. All right. So let's do this one in tricep. Let's do this one in tripod. All right, so I have my chaturanga arms. Maybe you're working on your tripod. I got a lot going on today, Donna. Maybe you're right here, and that's really cool. If you haven't, come on up. All right, eagle legs. I'm gonna cross my right knee over my left, wind it up. So now I want you to press your toes up towards the sky. So here you are in your headstand with eagle legs. All right, come on down. Let's try that on the other side. I'm gonna show you what the sideways view looks like. I'm gonna do this one in supported headstand.
Let me say this. If you are not inverted, don't even try this or go to a wall or something, okay? I'm not teaching this. I'm just showing you what else you can do with eagle legs.
All right. Supported headstand.
All right, this time, left knee is going over the right. Now, when I said to point your toes towards the sky, I meant to, all right, some of you might be here, right? I want you to lengthen the toes towards the sky. So this is your headstand with eagle legs, okay?
Take a child's pose. Breathe.
Walk yourself up.
Swing your legs around. Legs have been all kinds of bent up today. I'm going to take a minute just to kind of work mine out. That was a Saturday class, y'all. That was like some Jen is going to like throw this and that at me and be absolutely crazy.
You're welcome if you missed it.
All right, bend your knees as much as you need to. Inhale up. I have no idea where my husband went. Exhale, fold. He like went into the backyard and disappeared. Come on. We have more. Where's everybody going?
We're going to land. Dad said get dressed.
Oh, you look beautiful. I'm counting in 1 second. What was that, okay? Thank you. Slowly roll it up. Take your legs wide. I don't know what is going on right now. She looked adorable, but did she not? Alright, take a big inhale, tip forward. Exhale, begin to walk yourself down. So not a whole lot of hip opening in today's practice if you need that. Before you roll your mat up, take a pigeon. Take a lizard. I find that a lot of my practices do have a lot of hip openings, so I'm kind of okay with not doing it in this one. Plus, eagle isn't about hip opening at all. Eagle is very tight and together. We could have done those counter poses, but we didn't because we had a main objective today, right? So maybe this is really good right here, right now. Enjoy this. Walk it up. Legs together. Lie on down on your mat. Actually, let's take a happy baby. Set them up right here. All right, so tip your tail back down towards the mat. If you can't tip your tail down with your hands on your feet, grab the backs of your legs to tip your tail down. Press everything into the mat. Very slowly rock. Or not, or be still. I'm not one to absolutely say you have to do this ever.
Come back to center. Extend your left leg long, right knee in.
Take a twist, supine twist. Right knee is going to fall to the left side of the mat. Readjust your shoulders to your right arm. Bring the right knee back. Other side, left leg's coming in. Right leg long. Supine chest. Let that knee fall. Left arm in a T. Come back to center. Bring both knees in. Give yourself some love. Rock. Slay. I want you to bring your forehead up to your knees and create this tight little ball of light and love and energy and strength. Take a big inhale. Exhale, open it up. Find a place to rest. I am not going to guide you through your Shavasana today because I have children running in asking for things.
But I want you to take a rest. I want you to take a few moments to just be and to sit and to breathe and to thank your body for what it just did for you. I am so eternally grateful that I have been provided with people who allow me to be a part of their practice. I am so eternally grateful to be provided with people that can be a part of my practice. I will never be able to thank you enough. Until we meet again, it'll be soon. I know it will. I love you and I honor you and I see you. My light shines on your light and your light shines on my